Good morning, student. In previous lecture, we have completed our measurement of mutual inductance, where we have studied the Carey-Foster bridge. Till now, we have completed our measurement of self-inductance, measurement of capacitance, measurement of mutual inductance. Now, coming to the next topic, measurement of frequency in our AC bridge chapter. In previous bridges, we have some balance equation which involves the terms frequency directly, even if the individual bridge element is independent of the frequency, still we got the balance equations including the term of frequency. So these bridges may be used as a determination of frequency, but here in this part we will study about the Wien's bridge as a most important one to determine the frequency. So this Wien's bridge is known as for determining the frequency. Here, not only it is used in AC bridges, but it is also used in other application for various circuits. This Wien's bridge, for example, can be used for harmonic distortion analyzer, where it is used as a notch filter, discriminating against one specific frequency. The Wien's bridge also finds application in audio and HF oscillators as a frequency determining device. Now first look to the AC bridge of Wien's bridge. This is Wien's bridge diagram, where we have R1, R2, R3 and R4. We have C1, C2. All the terms are kind of known values. We have all the parameters as a known value. By the adjustment of this mechanical coupling, we will get this R1 is equals to R2 and RC1 is equals to C2. We will look this in further description. First, coming to the balance equation. At the balance equation, we will have Z1, Z4 is equals to Z2, Z3. Here Z1 is a parallel combination of C1, R1. We have taken R1 divided by 1 plus j omega C1, R1 multiplied by R4 is equals to R2 minus j divided by omega C2 multiplied by R3, because this one is in series, R2 and C2 are in series. Solving the above equation or simplifying that equation, we will get R4 divided by R3 is equals to R2 by R1 plus C1 by C2 plus J in bracket omega C1 R2 minus 1 by omega C2 R1. By equating the real term, we will directly have R4 by R3 is equals to R2 by R1 plus C1 by C2. And by equating the imaginary part, we will have omega C1 R2 minus 1 by omega C2 R1 equals to 0. So we will have our omega is equals to 1 by under root of R1 R2 C1 C2. So substituting the value of omega, we have 2 pi f. The value of f will directly equals to 1 by 2 pi under root of R1 R2 C1 C2. In most of the Wien's bridge, the components we've chosen that are R1 is equals to R2, will be equals to R, and C1, C2 will be equals to capital C. So from our real term, we will have R4 by R3 is equals to 2, because we have taken this R, where we have R1 by R2 plus C1 by C2. So we will have 1 plus 1, that is equals to 2. Now reducing the imaginary part, we will have f is equals to 1 divided by 2 pi RC. The switches of resistor R1, R2 are mechanically linked so as to fulfill the condition of R1 and R1 is equals to R2. We have discussed this. As long as C1 and C2 are fixed capacitor, which are having an equal value, and R4 is equal to 2 times of R3. The Wien's bridge may be used as a frequency determining device balanced by a single control. The bridge is suited for the measurement of frequency from 100 Hz to 100 kHz. It is possible to obtain the accuracy of 0.1 to 0.5% because of frequency sensitivity in the Wien's bridge may be difficult to have a balance point unless the waveforms of the applied voltage is sinusoidal. So we have a kind of difficulty in obtaining a balance point due to the frequency sensitivity. The bridge is not balanced for any harmonics present in the applied voltage. If we are having some harmonics in our applied voltage, the bridge may not be balanced. So these harmonics will sometimes produce output voltage masking the true balance point. This difficulty can be overcome by connecting a filter in series with null detector so that the balance point can be found out. The Wien's bridge may be used for the measurement of capacitance also. Now we have completed our measurement of frequency here. We have only one bridge as a Wien's bridge in the measurement of frequency. In next lecture, we will study about the errors in AC bridges and their elimination methods. For now, this is all. The lecture notes will be provided to our college website. For any query, you can write me. Till then, continue our lectures. Stay healthy, stay safe.